Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Nina, and this is A Wheelie Good Life. A lot has changed since we last spoke. It is now Sunday, April the 5th, and we are officially in, well, a COVID-19 pandemic, coronavirus. Here in Australia, we've begun, essentially it's lockdown, but they're calling it social distancing. So what I was saying was, sorry about that, I got cut off. My battery in my GoPro ran out of charge, so I just had to charge that back up. But what I was saying, that was essentially my life has changed quite a bit lately. I'm now working from home full time, and I'm avoiding all public places. I don't go shopping, I don't go to the mall, I don't actually kind of really go anywhere. I go out once a day to exercise, and that's as per health recommendations, health advice. But all of my contact now is done by Zoom. I still have kept my disability support workers doing their shifts, but we modify things so that we're out more than what we're inside the house, and in just to maintain social distancing. I'm actually quite enjoying this as a more of a cocoon time. Like, it's quiet. I've got my job, so therefore I've still got purpose in my life. I know it's a really hard time across the world, and a lot of people have lost their jobs, and it's really difficult. But for me personally, I'm enjoying it, to be honest. I'm actually spending a lot more time cooking and reading and doing my yoga practice, and I'm enjoying it. But what I wanted to do in this vlog was, because I can no longer go out into busy places, I handed the camera over to my support worker, Lisa, and she became my eyes and ears to the world. So this footage was taken a few days ago. I hope that you like it. Please excuse Lisa, she's not the best vlogger, but she steps up to every challenge that I give her, and the fact that she actually gave it a crack was truly amazing, I think. But you know, anyway, hope you like it. Please let me know if you do, let me know how you're going actually. And I'm going to have to edit this because I'm rambling, but I just really want you to take care, be safe, wash your hands, stay home, and just really look after yourself mentally as well as physically during this time. Love you guys. I'll see you next time. Now I'll hand over to Lisa.
Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday the 28th of March, and I'm here in Nina's home. Nina's out, so we're doing social distancing so I can still come to work, which is something that I really appreciate. Got my gloves on, and what I'm doing this morning, there's a whole list of tasks that I need to do, but the first one being, I've got the disinfectant wipes, and of course I've got my gloves on, and I've been going down wiping all the surfaces, so fridge doors, handles, bench tops, all the PowerPoints in the house, table, anything that you can touch that germs can get on quite easily because they're used all the time, I'm wiping them down. Obviously this is something that she does regularly, but while there's no one in the house, I can get in and get it all done, so it's limiting any germs on the surfaces that we touch a lot of the time. Reluctantly, I got given a project, as Nina calls it, where I have to take you out for the day to show you what it's like in the world while this is going on. When I say world, in the community. So I'll be taking you along, and just for the day, to show you what people are actually doing, and if anyone's actually practicing the social distancing and self-isolation. So we'll see. Okay, so I've just pulled up to the hair supplier. So I'm gonna get Nina some supplies that she'll have to do herself while we're in this, bit of a lockdown, isn't it? We're not really at a lockdown, but I think we should be, and so we have to get prepared for these things. So I am at the hair suppliers. I'm just about to go in, and I will try and do a bit of filming just in there, just to not to show you what's in there, but more just to see if there's people actually out and about. I'm the only car here, so I can't imagine that there's going to be anyone but me in there, but I'll let you know. So here I am inside the hair suppliers, and I was actually a bit shocked to see how many people are in here. see if I can kind of, well, I can't really show you them, but there's a few people in here, but everyone seems to be maintaining their distance, which is good. There's still a world going on. Here I am in the hairdresser's warehouse where we get all of our supplies from. There's a few pairs of colours that we're going to stock up on. The shop's still open, business as usual. Everyone's kind of keeping their distance, which is good. Yeah, so we're out and about and life still goes on. Alcohol wipes and tissues. Okay, so I've just come out of the hair suppliers and there's lots of people in there now. The warehouse itself is huge. So there's probably about 15 people in there at the moment, but there's plenty of room to have 3 meters each. And everyone's practicing safe social distancing at the moment while I was in there, which is good. Hand sanitized just before I went in. I've just come out now and I've hand sanitized and then I'm going to hand sanitize again. I'm doing that a lot. I'm going to run out of hand sanitizer, but you don't realize how much you actually touch your face and other surfaces until now, until you're made aware of it. That's been pretty hard on, I've got some mental health conditions and one of them is OCD, and it's not, generally it's not washing my hands 50 billion times, but I've always been aware of people touching different surfaces and then me touching it. So I've always had hand sanitizer and it eases my mind, but I've noticed since Corona has come on board, it's playing on my mind a little bit more. I will admit it's definitely, it's had a bit of an impact. And I was already aware of this, but it's making me hypervigilant. So I'm really recognizing everything, even in my home with the kids being home, touching stuff. So we've got hand sanitizers everywhere. We've got disinfectant wipes everywhere. We've got hand soap. We're going through that a lot because we're forever, wash your hands. Just little things like the kids colouring in and doing their homeschooling. So they're touching their pencils, scratching their face, whatever, then they're going to eat. And oh, have you washed your hands? And they're normal things, but it's you don't realise how much people touch stuff until you're made aware of it. So even now I've hopped in my car and I know I've got to touch the steering wheel, the handbrake, I've touched the handle of the car. So I kind of use my hand sanitizer when I get in. Then when I go to get out, I touch it again, use it again. And even now, scratching my nose, it's just these things that you used to just do are now making you more aware of it, which I think is a good thing for some people that didn't have any worry about things before. Maybe it'll make them realize that they were a little bit maybe unhygienic. Okay, so I'm leaving the hair supplies now. I'm gonna head off to Pam's house, lovely lady who has actually been sewing masks for people in the community that require them. So I'm gonna go and pick them up and continue on. All right, just about to get out of the car at Petstock. So let's go and see if there's many people wandering around in this shop. So this is what's in place. There's crosses that people are allowed to stand on. No one else is allowed to go in that space. It's all from social distancing. And they've got the payment. There's no cash. It's all done through card. So they've got it set up. So as people come up, there's crosses the whole way. Then they scan it from here. You do not go over the counter and you pay on the card. Taking it very seriously, which is great. Thank you. Back in the car, I'm pretty impressed with the way that they've got things set up, but if they're going to be open, they need to be safe. And so they were lovely. They let me film in there to show you the way that they're doing things, which is kind of nice for people that can't get out into the community to realize that people are taking these things seriously. If they have to be open, they need to be safe. Everyone needs to be safe. So I'm pleased to say that Petstock are doing it the good way. Okay, so I've just been and picked up the masks from Pam. Yeah. They're awesome. Look how cool it looks. Anyway, back to it. So I've just gotten home from work. The kids are screaming. You can hear them in the background. And then I've got Flynn out here doing some chalk work on the floor. And the girls are inside screaming at each other. This is a reality of having kids and working and trying to fit everyone in and everyone having their own voice. And it's exhausting. It's anxiety provoking, but this is life with children. So I've just made myself a cup of coffee and the kids have stopped screaming at each other for longer than a few minutes. So I've got to keep the kids entertained as well, and we can't leave. So this is what they're up to. And what does this say, Flynn? Can you tell me what it says?
COVID-19 and it equals in hospital and the thermometer is all the way up.
So COVID-19 equals hospital bed. Is that right?
Yeah, but there's somebody on it because they've got it.
Oh, there's someone already on the hospital bed.
See?
Yep. What about you, Sienna? What are you up to?
Well, I'm just trying to write random words in it, see if it makes a sentence. I've got nothing else to do.
So they're getting along for the moment, which is nice. Doesn't happen all the time. So I'm going to sit here with my coffee for a minute. You'll be able to hear the cars going past as I live on a main road. Just wanted to have a little bit more of an in-depth chat, I guess, about mental health and how this is all having an impact with the virus. I have three kids and one of them has some severe mental health conditions, and something that keeps her well is structure. So getting up at a certain time, going to school, getting the bus, all that, coming home and knowing what she's got on the afternoons, that keeps her well. So of course, with her not being at school, she's not getting up, she's not getting on a bus, she's not doing that. So it doesn't matter how much we try and replicate things here to a schedule for her, it's having a huge negative impact. which then of course has the flow-on effect. So trying to help her maintain her mental health, it's a struggle. It's a huge struggle, especially when you've got mental health issues yourself at times. So trying to keep her going, and there's lots of negative impact for her. A lot of it comes in the form of rage and frustration, and then the violence. So this is something that we're trying to get all the help that we can. We've got a team of professionals in place. This also impacts me, so it's making me stress more trying to make sure that she's safe and okay, but then it also has effect on the other two. So the other two are growing up seeing this. So in a way it's good they're exposed to different kind of mental health conditions, but it's also it's a worry for them as well. So I've got to try and maintain everybody as well as myself to make sure that everyone is okay, and if they're not, that I'm available for them to talk to, or help them find someone that they feel comfortable talking to. So we do different sorts of things. So my middle child, she likes to be left on her own, and she deals with her emotions through art. So she likes to draw. She loves doing schoolwork, so she'll sit there for hours at a time doing her schoolwork, and you don't hear boo from her, but she likes to be kind of more secluded. And then my youngest one, well, he's just full on, and he likes to keep me busy. So just trying to have them all be unique, but then also make sure that they're all well adjusted as well and understand that they've got the support. What are you doing, bud?
Mum.
Oh, thank you.
He's just trying to say hi.
And then you get nice cuddles like that, and it kind of brings everything back down. Flynn's my one that when I get a bit worked up, sometimes I get anxious, or he can just see that I'm not myself. He always comes up and gives me hugs, and that for me just makes me calm, brings me back to reality, and it kind of gives me a bit of mindfulness in that moment. It just brings me back. And yes, Sienna?
Can I say something? Yesterday the ice cream van came past and we got ice cream, and I got the double cone with choc, vanilla ice cream and sprinkles.
And I got a single choc and
vanilla ice cream.
It was like hardy and all foaming, and then I just like and sucked the whole thing up.
My favourite ice cream flavour is mint, and then my favourite cupcake flavour is red velvet.
And I actually got an ice cream too yesterday, and that was actually good because I messaged them so that they could come. Obviously the kids can't go out, so the Ken's Cones came, pulled up out the front, got our address, and it was nice. They asked us what we wanted. She made it, put it down, stepped back. She had gloves on, so then there was a social distancing there. So there was a bit of fun for them. They got the ice cream from the ice cream van. I actually got a double choc with a flake too. It was actually quite nice.
I made it sharp.
So that's just a little bit of what we'll be talking about anyway. So I've got my coffee. The kids have got their chalk.
My hands are
all. And we'll see what happens later on. Okay, it's 3:11 in the afternoon. I've just hopped in the car. I'm going to go pick up a workout exercise band from the gym. They're having someone outside selling, so you can just come in, social distancing, go. So you're not actually going inside the gym. And I also am using this as a little bit of a break from the kids. I've not even that long been home from work, and oh god, it's exhausting. It's exhausting. They're just arguing. They don't have iPads at the moment, so usually this is what parents do. They've got iPads, they chill out, and you just be like, okay, good, don't have to deal with you. So we've taken the iPads away, so they can't just be on it all the time. But that in itself is a feat, because they just argue, they're bored. So we have to do stuff with them. board games, playing chalk. They're fixing the fence at the moment, but I'm just taking this opportunity to take a few minutes out, recharge, and then come back to it. Two of the kids are having a sleepover tonight at my mum's. Yay! So I've only got one child home tonight, so that'll be nice. No fighting. Okay, just been down to grab my stuff from the gym. Very good, didn't have to touch anyone, put the money in a box, grabbed a thing out ourselves, and hand sanitizer as soon as I come back in. So I just went and got this beauty. It's actually called a booty band. So you use this, it's like a resistant band that you use for doing exercises, and seeing as I'm going to be doing exercises at home instead of at the gym, that'll help with some resistance, so I don't have to have equipment. I can just, you know, put this on. You just put it around your legs, and then, yeah, so you do your exercises so you've got some resistance. And they gave me magazine too. I don't actually go to this gym anymore, but I just wanted to support where I could. So, awesome. So now, next, better get my ass back home. Okay, I'm back home. I'm just going to sit here. Silence. No arguing. I just need to bring chocolate and then I could just sit here and I'd be happy. This is what we do. This is what mums do. You take these moments when you can and then you're ready to go fight again. Go back in there and do it all over again. This is what we do. And hide in cars so we can not have to deal with it all.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
We're in the middle of driving.
And we're on our way again, back in the car.
In the car.
To take the kids to my mum's house for a sleepover.
Well, I'm not sleeping over this week, but I'm sleeping over next week.
So swap
with.
I'm just sitting down. It is 5:45 p.m. I've got two of the kids staying at mum's and the other one's in the shower at the moment, so I've got a few minutes to kind of just chill for a bit, and then I'll have a shower and then do something with Sienna a bit later. I guess I just wanted to talk a bit about my role as a support worker. So when I work with Nina, we were out doing things together, and she vlogs all that, so you get to see everything that we get up to. But we access the community a lot. Nina's big on community engagement, and I think that for Nina, that's good for her mental health. And it's fun. It's fun getting out there and seeing what the world has to offer. So I'm super lucky. So I get to drive Nina around in generally her own van, which I love to drive because it's brand new. Otherwise, we get wheelchair taxis, which all the taxi drivers are awesome as well. But since this COVID-19, things have changed for everyone. And so my role in supporting Nina has changed. Obviously, she doesn't need to go out and do all the things that she was doing. As you saw earlier, she was out in Kangaroo Valley, isolated, but outside. And that I think that's good. It keeps, you're outside, you're out of the four walls, you're in nature, you're accessing the community safely. And that's what this is about. This is about safety for people that are more vulnerable to the COVID-19. I myself am not worried for me, but I'm worried for other people. People like Nina, people like my grandparents. My dad has a heart condition. So there's so many people that we really have to be careful around, and social distancing, I know, kind of seems really hard to some, but it's really easy when it comes to someone's health and someone's life. I saw something on Facebook the other day, and it said, if this virus was attacked young people or middle-aged people, our parents and grandparents wouldn't risk it. They would stay indoors to keep us safe and to keep their grandchildren safe. Yet it's the other way around, and it's the elderly and the immune compromised that are at higher risk, and young children. Yet everyone's still out. Everyone's seems to be still going about their everyday life. Cafes, you can't eat in them, yet you see everyone standing outside in close space waiting for their order. I just don't think people understand how quick that this gets spread and how life-threatening it can be for someone that has a compromised immune system, that has any kind of condition. Cancer patients, like my children have severe asthma when they're sick. I have asthma, but I'm not worried for me, but I've avoided my grandparents, which I'm finding difficult. And then there's me as a support worker, who I'm very aware that Nina is at risk. So I'm being very careful. I'm not accessing the community, and I love to get out there. I'm not doing it. I stopped going to the gym before they closed, and that was my choice. I stopped doing any of my social events, and this was all because I wanted to keep Nina safe. And if Nina was safe, then I'd still have a job. So it all works together. There's lots of support workers that don't want to risk it and don't want to work. And then there's lots of participants that need the support workers and they don't want to risk their health, or they can't. So I think it's really hard for especially the higher needs participants that need that care. And there's a big gap. There is a big gap. And support workers like myself, if you don't turn up to work, you don't get paid. So then there's also running the risk of, well, people will come to work because they need the money, but then they're also risking their health and the health of their clients. So it's kind of tough. So for me, I'm playing it safe for not only for me and my family, but for Nina and for the people that are vulnerable out there. And so I've been lucky that Nina has been able to assign me tasks to get done so I can still get paid. And I really appreciate that. Nina knows that. And as you know, because I'm in front of the damn camera, Nina sent me a project to do. And it was how this COVID-19 affects me and a day as a support worker. So I've taken you out to do the errands that I had to do for Nina today. I know that I don't do this as good as Nina does, but hell, I gave it a go, and we'll see how the editing goes on Nina's end. Looking forward to seeing what she actually does with this. So thank you, Nina, for setting this project. And yes, I sit and wait.